I was on standby to go to Iraq. So I did my will, sea bag was packed, lock cocked, ready to go. I was one of those few Marines, female Marines, African-American Marines at that, who was able to go places and do things that your average Marine did not get to do or see. And then I got a call that I didn't have to go. So I was so relieved, but I had already had all the vaccinations. And I had a very, very bad reaction to the anthrax vaccinations. They told me that I was suffering from Gulf War syndrome. And I had an infant at the time. You know, he was fairly new to the world. My disabilities are many, and they're unseen. I live in pain every day, every day. I walk around the house, sometimes in just circles, not knowing what I'm supposed to do next. I stare off into space and have to snap back somehow. My mind, memory loss. The anthrax caused a whole bunch of things. You know, there's so many things that go on that I have to live with personally that people don't even know, that they have no idea about. When your life takes a transition from fast track to almost no track, how do you get back? How do you find your way back? How do you pick up those pieces that were broken from your whole self, of what you used to be, and the journey that you were on? And so it has made my life a living hell. The motivating factor for me coming to college was the fact that I felt compelled to leave a legacy for my child, being a military-born baby. I've got this GI Bill, you know, that was promised me. I paid into it. So going to college was one way for me to be able to pass that on. I'm committed enough and courageous enough to put myself in school. I use assistive technology to help me auditorially remember. It helps me because I'm a slow reader now. I don't read fast anymore. I don't comprehend it when I read it. I've found myself reading paragraphs over and over and over again, stuck on one page for 30 and 45 minutes. Sitting in a classroom, it's painful. I have a short attention span. I try to sit up front so I can stare the teacher in the eye, so I can make sure I'm trying to listen. But it's sometimes hard to grasp what they're saying because I get it mixed up. So I hear one thing, but they're telling me something else. That didn't used to happen to me. It's one teacher that told me that I got the assignment all wrong. I wasn't listening when I am very attentive, but it's just that I got it mixed up because of my disability. So it is those, when a teacher makes you feel like you're stupid, you know you're not stupid, and you know that something isn't connecting, but you don't want to be made to feel like you don't belong in that classroom. Thank God for assistive technology. That's helping me tremendously and keeps me on focus. We're behind already when we come into the classroom because of our disabilities. So we need to be able to get our books ahead of time, because that will help us to be able to not go in stressed, because we already have the stress of our disabilities that we have to live with on a daily basis. Rather than handouts, visuals, being more creative in the classroom, using visual aids with examples that can drive home a point better than just words on a piece of paper, would make, for me, things stick a little bit more, and I'm sure people like me. With this education, I'm going to be able to write the play that I've always wanted to write. I'm going to be able to write the songs that I've always wanted to be able to sing. And I just want my child to know that no matter what, I want him to have an education so that he can become a responsible person in society, to help, to not be a burden on society, a liability on society, but to become an asset to society. And I feel that my role as a parent, as a student, is an example for him to just become that much better. I'm going to recite a portion of a poem that I wrote called Obstacles Overcome. Although obstacles continue to show up at my life's door, uninvited, with its cunning deception, always conniving its way into my space, as it seeks to lure me into a fight, blinded by its own eyes so full of hate, obstacles just do not see that it cannot and will not defeat me.
LaDonna's suggestions. Ask students if they require alternative ways to interact with the material. Ensure that students are fully engaged in classroom activities. Use methods that give a feeling of belonging in the classroom. Adopt and make textbooks available early enough for conversion to alternate formats. Use visual aids to accompany lectures and oral presentations.